First of all, thank you so much for everybody coming over. I could not expect a morning filled with everybody in the room, experts, right? And pardon me for my husky voice. I think weather, Delhi, Bombay is banging on my throat. So pardon me for that. I'm really excited to launch the report, as you know. So this is our second edition for the problematic report that we have done this year. Last year again with E4M we had launched it. So last year when we were talking about the report, the main concepts and the talking points were that how problematic is at an evolution, especially post-pandemic. Everybody was trying to see what advertising world is holding for us, especially post-pandemic. Traditional is moving towards digital, digital is going heavy towards programmatic. And I'm extremely happy to say that within this 1 year span of time, programmatic had not just been evolved, but had gone in a space where, rightly Naval said, that people are not comfortable talking about it because it's become so advanced. So today when we're talking about the key trends in terms of programmatic, clearly one big word that's coming here is discovery commerce. I'll just talk about why we're calling it discovery commerce and not just a media commerce. Then AI, so as we know that AI is not just a buzzword anymore, but something which is very much important, a pillar of growth, like we know our premium partner Cybers with us, right? You need to have it to have a very much optimized campaign, and amplified intelligence is what I'll call, and not just an AI. Followed by creative post-programmatic, where you'll see that it's not just about how you talk about TCO campaigns or you talk about, you know, creative renditions happening, but furthermore, where you marry data and technology and AI and measurement, everything together with programmatic in a creative format, where you understand that how with different channels it's being worked together. So let me just, you know, open this report for you and talk about the first thing, which is the big bet of 2023. And why are we calling it a big bet of 2023? For a very clear reason. All of us in this room, yes, we know we were forced to go online when pandemic happened, but now that's a new normal for all of us. I don't even remember when was the last time when I went offline for shopping anything. A, because I don't have that time. B, I don't have that patience. C, the kind of ease I've got on online, because every brand has been investing so much of time and energy and of course a lot of money to make that journey easy for users and audiences. So when that kind of investment is happening, clearly audiences are also moving towards an online world for everything that they want to buy, which is a marketplace in e-commerce. And we know, right, brands, that wherever audiences are, we are there. So clearly advertising, when it comes to e-commerce, it's not just a line item, but a channel in itself where we have a huge growth. Now, we talk about that, why are we betting huge on e-commerce? It could be just another platform, right? But the thing is, we need to look at it a perspective that when digital evolved almost a decade ago, it started with search media and also social media. These were the two words that we all had been hearing back then. Entire campaign was built on a huge, humongous list of keywords, and then of course followed by social media. And then we could see media separately booming in, where we talked about omni-channel strategies, especially last 2 years, working upon those things. But do we not resonate same happening in commerce as of today? Because when we're working on our commerce strategy, we again talk about keywords, which is brand keywords, competition keywords, which page do I need to be in, which product do I need to, you know, qualify myself for heavy investments. But we need to understand that, again, similar to media advertising, digital advertising, the way we have social and search, within commerce, we have search commerce, we have social commerce, and then we have entire bouquet of audiences which is sitting for a discovery commerce, which is media commerce. Now, why do we call it discovery? Very clear reason that when audience is trying to make up his or her mind to buy something, they're in a mood of a discovery. So you could be very clear on the fact that what product you want to buy could be a refrigerator, but when you're searching for it about reviews or maybe in a phase when you've not made up your mind which brand you want to go for, you're still discovering it. So as advertisers, we see there's a huge gap in terms of our strategies because we are planning for the bottom funnel in commerce, which is where we have heavy investment on search commerce. People have already made up their mind in terms of the brand that they want to go for, but what about the time when they were in that journey? So which is where we're leaking it in a way, and we need to invest on our strategy, understand that how can we tap them in that decision-making journey, which is why we're calling it as a discovery commerce, that audiences are trying to discover the brands they want to go for. And similarly, marketeers, we need to understand that how differently our strategy needs to be shaped for that duration. So it is not just a bottom funnel solution, but end-to-end funnel solution, which is how do you work on awareness, and then creating an intent, and then followed by a purchase activity that you go for. So in the report, you can read more about it. Not taking a lot of time, we'll move to the next key trend, which you'll see, which is amplified intelligence. Again, why are we not calling it artificial intelligence? Is clearly because when AI is just built on back of tech algorithms, models, right? But that's made by humans. So when humans are meeting artificial intelligence, that's when it becomes a magic, which is amplified intelligence. And gone back are the days when you used to just talk about, you know, lowering down CPMs or CPVs using AI. Now are the days when you say that AI is actually helping you in taking decisions, starting from planning your campaign, which is insight-led campaign, followed by activation, and then even insights after the campaign is done. And even, of course, on the go decision making that you're doing. So it's a lot of decision making tree, which AI is helping you to try to build that. And of course, we're seeing a lot of efficiency. So instead of investing heavy, basically I'll say, in a manual strategies that we have been working along back then, is the time when we are building a lot of dashboards with the help of these millions and trillions of data sets. And as we know that the world is going cookieless, all of this is happening. So of course, no matter how much you devise your strategies, whatever we keep on reading upon, but we need to have that insight coming in from data. And a lot of models which will be built on the back of algorithm, where you work on top funnel, of course, CTV, CPMs, massive reach you know, go for, then you have viewability, then you have measurement coming in. And again, if today we talk about one big key challenge that everybody faces is, how do you map my journeys together? So most of the brands, if you talk about it, their awareness campaigns are done by one agency, while performance is mostly done by another. But that's now how an audience flow is going in. And those were the days when, of course, world was not omnichannel for advertising, when it was still a walled garden. So yes, it made sense. But today, when entire world is omnichannel, in fact, we're going towards advanced omnichannel, which is not just digital, but how beyond you're going with it, which is how do you connect offline with online? How do you connect retail with online? So if within online, the world is not connected for you in terms of your media investment, I think that's a big red flag. So that's what we are seeing today, that with the help of programmatic, you're connecting your entire awareness campaign funnel with your performance-led campaigns, for which, of course, you need to have an AI in place. And that entire set of algorithms are setting you up for a strategized campaign deliveries, where, of course, in a span of time, but you understand that how do you increase your delta, how do you further get more efficient, ROAS-driven campaigns. And I clearly see that when we talk about performance campaigns, there were times when we used to talk about, you know, how much conversions am I getting. But even in terms of our measurement, those entire metrics are gone. So if you look at your measurement tools now, you clearly see, you know, data-driven attributions. So attribution models are in place just for understanding the fact that awareness campaigns plays a bigger role, and there's a weighted average that needs to be given to awareness campaigns. So when such changes are being done by, you know, big players like Google in their measurement tool, same needs to be reflected in our media strategies too, which is where we have AI, which is further helping us, becoming a pillar to us, navigating this journey for us. And followed by that, as we are talking about creative post programmatic, so we are not talking about creativity this year because we have talked about it last year, that how, you know, DCO marrying with data and technology navigates the world for you. But there's a big trend coming up for us. The way we could see e-commerce booming for us, in next 2 years, we'll see voice taking over that world. So voice is actually going to shape the future for programmatic for us within the scope of creativity. I'll tell you how and why. Past 2 years, I remember there was a gifting idea, Alexa, being given to everybody in all corporate events, personal events, right? So be it bought, be it gifted, but yes, most of people have Alexas at home now. Very well used. And since we have a device, you know, let's get a house, a little bit change is done. So of course, things are very much, again, voice driven in our houses too, which is a consumption. So when adoption is having in terms of consumption, clearly there are audiences, again, sitting there. And as we all know, we never lose an opportunity. Wherever we are able to understand our audiences, we get there within our advertising world. So in the next 2 years, and which is something not new, because across different parts of the world, it's happening. So again, in India, this trend is gonna come, where most of our, instructions in terms of buying or going somewhere, navigation in our daily life, will be driven by voice assistance. and which is where even advertising landscape is taking us. So we had done a campaign for Pizza Hut as a test, which was done, a few months ago, where again a campaign was done where a person could talk to the voice. So instead of a creative or one-sided audio campaign, a voice is asking you that, hey, it's a Wednesday, a BOGO, would you want to try a pizza? So out of curiosity, many people said yes and no, just to test. And then another creative comes in, depending on the answer being given, which would open a landing page for you or which would again come back to you in the evening. But the thing is that in this way, today, day-to-day life, when we're so busy, voice is taking over that world for you. So it's making, for us advertisers, entire creative landscape as more conversational. So it's not a journey where you're just waiting for a click to happen and where you end up losing your audiences, but a journey where people are conversing back to you. So it's more of conversational, more of engagement-driven creative formats being put into picture and place. And also when I talk about creative goes programmatic, we know, yes, as I say, it's a blessing in disguise. Pandemic had been bad and worse for all of us. But the reality is that we're sitting here and we have changed ourselves, our ways of living, with whatever happened and new ways of normal living. But the thing is, with this, within advertising, we have seen massive changes happening. It did not just connect the world together on humanity grounds, but also in the form of advertising, we could see people trying to navigate entire workflow, their landscapes for ease of consumers, which connected the worlds together. I can see digital connecting with offline. I can see digital connecting with retail. When I see digital connecting with offline, there was a time when offline brands hardly used to invest on digital with the fact that my audiences cannot buy online. But pandemic has pushed us towards that edge, and now that is staying with us forever. So there are campaigns being done digitally to create awareness, to create an intent, where yes, the audience is being guided to go towards an offline store today. Could be a car, automotive category, where your creative gives you an option to click on a button, which is tap to map. You click on the button and map opens up, it shows the direction. So that's another omni-channel advanced version which we are seeing, where you're not just talking about OTT platforms, working in the one landscape or audio talking to OTT, not just within digital but beyond digital. So which is what we have advanced omni-channel landscape, where you have your DOH campaigns connecting back to your digital. So that's, yes, a boom for all of us, because we don't need to slice and dice our media budgets as per many channels. We can keep this under one umbrella and see how technology and data can do those wonders for us. And clearly last one is navigating a cookie-less world, because everybody, every client is trying to seek for it, that how will that work for us. Again, I'll say don't panic, because if all these changes so rapidly in just 2 years we could absorb and ride on them, this is not something where we are not prepared. India as a market, we knew that these changes are gonna happen and they're coming our way. So yes, we're prepared. A lot of technology has already been kind of surfacing on the top, which we can see. So one word we all hear is contextual, right? That let's move towards contextual ways of targeting, not just a keyword targeting is what I'm trying to say, but more to do with context of the audiences, more to do with relevance of audience groups working out together, and even on the back of, again, data sets which are going to flow back in your campaign. And as we know that first party data is driving the growth and factor there, every advertiser is working towards that, and that remains one of the top priority for them. But again, at the same time, as you know that we can't take data back, it's been a long time, so what's gonna really help us is, again, those tech and tools. So that's going to be the heavy area of investment that we need to focus on. That's it, thank you. And I really hope that you really enjoy reading entire report. Thank you.